Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh, brothers and sisters. Thank you for joining us for the fifth lesson of our series, How to Live the Life of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Inshallah, today we're going to be discussing another etiquette for visiting the washroom. And this is an etiquette that many a times we do make compromises in due to having a digital device accessible to us. Many a times we're taking these digital devices, whether it's going to be our phones or tablets, into the washroom, and we're actively engaging with them as we are relieving ourselves. So whether that's going to be in terms of chatting, whether it's going to be in terms of taking a call or even making a call or even sometimes FaceTiming, these are things that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala does not approve of. We find in a hadith that our beloved Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam has said, two men should not go out to defecate in a manner that they expose their private parts and engage in a conversation while relieving themselves. فَإِنَّ اللَّهَ عَزَّ وَجَلَّ يَمْقُتُ عَلَى ذَلِكَ اللَّهُ عَزَّ وَجَلَّ loathes this. This hadith has been reported by Abu Dawood in his Sunan. And we can clearly see that the act of engaging in a conversation while relieving ourselves is something that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala clearly disapproves of. Now remember, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam is talking in a time or speaking in a time when people didn't have designated washrooms and they were to go out of people's sight, whether individually or in small groups or even sometimes in pairs, and they would go to relieve themselves, but while doing so, there would be this utter disregard for trying to conceal one's intimate areas. And while relieving themselves, they would also be engaging in a conversation with the person that has accompanied them. So this is something that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala clearly does not approve of. This is something that we're supposed to be spending minimum time in, not extended time. And we know that when we are engaging with our digital devices while relieving ourselves, we are maximizing the time spent in the washroom when we should be minimizing it as much as possible. It is for this reason that our beloved Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, upon exiting the designated space, he would say ghufranak. He would ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for forgiveness. And this was over the time that has been lost in doing the dhikr of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala as you would typically do outside the washroom, whether that would be in the form of tasbihat or the tilawah of the Quran or even engaging in salah. Those are things that you cannot do while in the washroom. So our beloved Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam would ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for forgiveness over this lost time. And he would go ahead and resume whatever acts he was engaged in prior to relieving himself. So we can clearly see that this is a thing that we are supposed to spend minimum time in. Therefore, what we should all do, and this is as easy as pie, it's a piece of cake, don't take your digital devices to the washroom. It's as simple as that. You'll spend less time, you will get out quicker, and you'll be able to get a lot more things done. This is an etiquette that we should adopt as soon as possible. And we pray to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that He makes it easy for us to continue this journey on applying the different traditions and practices of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam in our lives. Until next time, assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.